Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ, and welcome back to the Lions franchise as we are now in the divisional round after defeating the Chicago Bears for the second straight year in the playoffs. But this round, we will take on a very good Los Angeles Rams team. Now, no more Jared Goff, but they still do have Todd Gurley at 99 overall and Aaron Donald at 95 overall. So this is going to be a very, very tough game. Now, before hopping into the second game in the playoffs for the Lions, Keon Knight has an upgrade, and you can see he is up to 86 overall with morale, but he's at 85 without it. And look at him. He is already the number 31 ranked receiver as a rookie. I mean, next season, or even the season after that, he could be easily top 10 in ratings. So let's get this game underway. Here is Carey Reedy back to receive the opening kickoff as our home stand is over. We did host a playoff game in the wild card game, but now we're in LA. So first play of the game, handoff, Carey Reedy, and there is Aaron Donald with the hit in the backfield. That's a loss of 2 yards. So at the 24-yard line, here for a second and 12. They send the blitz. Here's a deep shot across the middle. That's one-on-one. Keon Knight almost gets it, but it's going to be knocked away by Johnson. And now we bring it to a third and 12 at the 24. Five wide receivers out there. Fields, he's going to get sacked. That is Aaron Donald in for the sack. And they do force the three and out already. And out comes Adrian Martinez from the University of Nebraska, 3,200 yards in his third season. He's reached the playoffs twice in his 3 years as a starter. So here he is starting this game out under center. First throw out to the right side. He's got Gerald Everett with a lot of speed. He breaks the tackle and gets pushed out of bounds. The first pass goes for 31 yards and a first down. So now from the 43-yard line, this time Martinez from the shotgun throws another catch by Gerald Everett. And it's going to be about a gain of 3 yards, and that brings up a third and four just out of field goal range from the 40. Throw across the middle. It's going to be picked off, intended for Cooper Kupp, and that's Rich Patton. Man, is Rich Patton going to be one rich guy or what? No pun intended, but this guy is amazing. 24 years old, superstar X-Factor, and he's just getting better. So here back on offense, here's a handoff. This time, Carey Reedy, he will get about a gain of 4 yards, and it brings up an eventual third and three. Throw across the middle. It's TJ Hockenson, our highest rated guy on the roster. He picks up a first down. So from the 46-yard line, three wide receivers out there, and Hockenson fields, throws to the right. He's got Galladay having himself an amazing season this year. He almost picks up the first down as that brings it to a third and one at the 44. Handoff, Kennedy Brooks. Look at him breaking tackle, still on his feet, and stumbles forward to about the 33-yard line, and a first down here for the running back in his third season. So now from the 27-yard line, third and four, here's a throw across the middle, another catch, and another first down. This time it's that's Keon Knight, actually. And now we get it to about the 20-yard line under center this time. Play action fake to Keon, to Brooks, I meant. Here is Fields scrambling out to the right side, and he picks up a lot of room, and he gets to about the 8-yard line. Gain of 12 yards. I really hope he develops that superstar trait that Lamar Jackson has, because that will definitely help when scrambling in the backfield. So now he does miss a throw on a first and second down. Here on a third down, throw across the middle, and it was a wide open TJ Hockenson. He misses two wide open touchdown passes on that one, and we do end up settling for three. And out comes the Rams back onto the field, handing it off to Todd Gurley in a three-point deficit game, and they pick up the first down on that first carry. So on the next play, first and 10, here's Cooper Kupp getting the end around, and look at that juke move. He gets about 11 yards. None of our players have that ability. I'm surprised Keon Knight doesn't have that, because he has the speed and the change of direction. So here's Martinez on a third and six, throw out to the flats, and that's going to be a nice one-on-one tackle by Tracy Walker, and we do get them to the 43, and that's going to be enough for them to punt the ball away. So now here's Johnny Hecker to punt. But no, he's going to throw the ball, and it's going to be knocked away. Johnny Hecker in real life, I believe, runs the most fake punts. So I guess that's kind of lifelike. They do run a lot of fake punts in real life, and Sean McVay, too aggressive that time, it doesn't work. So here's Kerryon on the following drive, the first play, he's gone. Touchdown, Kerryon. And there is the explosive play, the big play ability of Kerryon. He is amazing when he gets the ball, and that's a big time run. It's 10-0 here for the Lions. So here back on an offense, here are the Rams trying to run the ball with Gurley, and that's a nice one-on-one tackle once again by Tracy Walker. We've stuck with him this entire franchise. Even though we've had opportunities to get better safeties, I really like Tracy Walker. So here's a throw out to the left side on a 3rd-and-11. They do convert there, and that's Gerald Everett on the sideline and a first down. So from the 36-yard line in the second quarter now, sending a blitz, and there is Trey Flowers. 3 straight double-digit sack seasons. This one's his career high, 15.5 in the regular season. As they get into a 3rd-and-15, throw across the middle. It's knocked away, trying to look for Everett again, and this time they will have to punt. So now in a 10-0 game, if we get another touchdown here, we're in control. Here's a throw across the middle. That's Galladay. I want to make him a lifelong Lion. It's a first down. So from the 35-yard line, this time Fields handed off to Kerryon. Another big hole. Look at him fighting forward. And he gets about a gain of 12. He's at 71 yards rushing off of just 5 attempts. So we get it to the 49-yard line here for a 3rd-and-7. Fields throws across the middle. It's Galladay again. First down. I really love, now that I have a great young receiver in Keon Knight, I kind of like the idea of having Keon Knight and Kenny Galladay as the 1-and-2 punch, along with Marlon Yarbrough or Tylan Wallace as that third guy. I really, really like this receiving core. Here's a throw across the middle, this time on a 2nd-and-3. There is the guy we were just talking about, Keon Knight. He gets to about the 15-yard line and another first down. We are burning some clock on this drive. Here's another handoff. This time it's Reedy again. 9 yards. He's just moving the ball at will in this one. As we get it to a 3rd-and-1 at about the 6-yard line at the 2-minute warning. Here is Reedy again. His 2nd of the game. 17-0 here for the Lions on the road. Remember, we did beat the Rams earlier this season, I believe in game number 3. And it looks like the same game plan we used last time, just sending pressure at Martinez, is working. And he hasn't been able to put together a good drive. So now here in a 2-minute warning setting, here is Martinez trying to scramble. And he's going down. Rich Patton. Wow, he ran into a truck that time. And now we call the timeout and we get another punt before half. So here we are with 55 seconds left. Can we drive the length of the field and just get some points on the board? There's a nice throw to Galladay. As we hurried up to the line here, not calling a timeout, we have 1 remaining. Throw across middle, Galladay again, but this time it's knocked away by Johnson. And that brings up a 3rd-and-10 at about the 47. Another throw, Galladay, he's got it. And that's a first down. As that gets us into field goal range, we're going to be smart and kick the field goal. But it's going to be wide to the right. Joe Gammon cannot knock it through, so we do not get any points. And here come the Rams back out onto the field here after the missed field goal. One last heave to the end zone. It's not going to make it there. It's going to make it to the 5. And it's going to be picked off. That is big play Slay. And that's an interesting play call. They could have kneeled it that time and went into halftime. But instead, they throw another interception. That might hurt Martinez's confidence going into half. Questionable call by Sean McVay. But we got the 17-0 lead going into halftime. So here we go to start the second half. We have shut down Martinez, and not to mention that last interception they threw at the end of the first half. Throw out to left side. This time he's got Everett again. They line up Everett everywhere. That time he was on the outside. It's a first down. So 1st-and-10 at about the 38-yard line. Martinez throws across the middle. That's a nice route run by, I believe that's Ryan Switzer. And on that play, he's going to be shaken up. So got in for 1 catch, and he's already hurt. So now at the 44-yard line, quick throw to the right side. It's going to be caught in that time, and it's going to be another first down, and that's Tajay Sharp in the game. And now they get it to the 32-yard line for a 2nd-and-8. They're moving the ball pretty well on this one. Todd Gurley carry, and he's got another first down. Finally, they're into scoring range. So we had to play some defense here with our backs against the wall. 3rd-and-10, throw out to the right side. He's got Everett again, and another first down by Everett. He's converted all their first downs on 3rd downs, it seems like. and now they are at the 13-yard line. Under center is Martinez. Quick throw out to left side, and that's going to be caught in a gain of 7 yards. And now they get it to a second and three at about the 7-yard line. Handoff, Gurley finds a crease, and he's showing some patience. It's a touchdown for Todd Gurley. They get on the board for the first time this game. It's still a 17-7 game, so we can protect this lead. So here is Fields back out onto the field, handing the ball off to Carey Reedy, who gets tackled, and take a look. He is shaken up on the play. So in comes Kennedy Brooks and Travis Etienne. Here's a throw out to the right side on the next play, second and nine, and it's caught. Keon Knight, another first down. So from the 48-yard line, first and 10, under center. Here's a throw across the middle. It's Hawkinson. He's open. Another catch for him. I love that security blanket. He doesn't put up the big-time stats, but he does just enough. I don't ask him to do a whole lot, but when I need him, he's always there. So here's Keon Knight getting the catch on the right side, and look at him. He is just dangerous. With the ball in his hands, you saw how the defense was kind of hesitating. They didn't want him to break it for a big play, so they didn't kind of bum rush him on that one. And it opens up a big, about 17-yard gain. So now we get it to the 16-yard line here for a third and six. Fields drops back, throws, and he may have dropped back a little too far on that one. Open man, but just a little underthrown, and we do settle for the field goal. So now in a 20-7 game, here is Martinez back out onto the field, under center this time. Throw across the middle. He's got Cooper Kupp, and that's about a gain of five. We've neutralized these receivers this game, and big play Slay is a big part of that. He's there on the tackle. So here on third and four, throw to the right side, looking for their receiver that time. That was Tajay Sharp, and that's knocked away again. Great defense played by the secondary in this one, and we forced another punt. So here is Travis Etienne checking in for the injured Carey Reedy. He gets eight on his first carry. And that moves us on to the fourth quarter, second and two. Play action fake. Here's Fields trying to get rid of it. He gets smacked by Aaron Donald and coughs it up. And Fowler is there to pick it up. And wow, now this game turns on its head with that strip sack. And now Martinez has an opportunity to make this a one-score game. So here is Gurley on the first play of the next drive. Handoff, and he's tackled by Jelani Tavai. And you can just see the job we're doing. 22nd ranked in the NFL in the regular season in rush defense. We've only allowed 51 in this game. So Martinez, from a third and eight perspective, throw to the end zone. He's got it, and that's Vincent McCloud. Interception number three. And wow, Martinez is just losing this game for them. He's forced about three throws. That was a bad throw on that one. But on the next play, look at this. Another strip sack on Justin Fields. Wow, we are just allowing them to stay in this game. Two fumbles by Fields, and now they have an opportunity once again to get on the board. So here is Martinez from the shotgun. He's going to try to scramble, and he's going to get – no, he gets away. And look at this. He makes it inside the two-yard line on that scramble. Gain of 15. I thought we had him in the backfield. And now they get it to the two-yard line for a first and goal. We send the blitz, and they don't block enough. We pretty much stuff their receivers at the line of scrimmage, and it forces a sack. And now that brings it to a third and goal at the five. Martinez throws to left side, deflected. Jelani Tavai on the coverage. And now it's fourth and goal at the five. What are they going to do? They are going to go for it. Here is Martinez. Fourth and goal. Another opportunity. It's deflected. And once again, what a great play. Chris Harris Jr. And wow, they had two short drives, and they cannot get any points on the board. So here we are back on our offense. We need to protect this ball and move this clock. Here is Fields. Throw to the right side. And that's almost a first down as we get it to the 28-yard line for a third and three. Here's another handoff. And look at this. Aaron Donald. That's why you have the big defensive players on defense, the guys that you pay a lot of money to, making clutch plays like that. And we have to punt this ball back to the Rams. So here is Martinez with another opportunity in this game, trying to put together a drive. There is a deflection that time and a knocked out of the hands of Gerald Everett as that brings it to a third and nine. Here's a deep shot down the left side, and it's going to be caught. The smallest guy on the field almost, Robert Woods, goes up and gets it. And wow, that's a big-time catch with a minute left here in this game. So the Rams do play hurry up here. They're not burning any timeouts. 45 seconds left. Here is a throw across the middle, and it's almost picked off by Rich Patton. That could have been another one for him. I mean, man, that was a terrible throw, and that brings it to a 4th and 8. This one could be the game at the 28-yard line. Here's Martinez, 3 wide receivers, and Gerald Everett. Throw to the left side. It's picked off. Tracy Walker. Wow. 4 interceptions by Martinez. We didn't even send that much pressure like I thought we would have to, but he just lost the game himself. And there it is. 4 interceptions as they do get a garbage time touchdown off of a late fumble, but it does make it 20-14. We still come away with the victory. And what a game here. Adrian Martinez throws 4 interceptions. Even Justin Fields threw an interception. No touchdowns thrown in this one. Kerry Reedy runs for 2 touchdowns, but he was shaken up, so we might be without Kerry Reedy. We will get an injury update after these stats here. And then defensively, man, what a game from Rich Patton. 2 sacks, an interception as well. Trey Flowers had a sack as well. And then also Tracy Walker, Vincent McLeod, and big play Slay had that interception at the end of the first half. So after this game, Justin Fields gets an upgrade and we will advance to another NFC championship. And that is quite the feat. A Lions team who's been to 3 straight NFC championships. Remember, we lost in year 1 to the Redskins. In year 2, we beat the Redskins. So we will find out who we will play next. Galladay has an upgrade. So does Brian Ryan. Everybody gets upgrades in this episode as we do kind of move into the later parts of the season where a lot of these accolades and all of these season goals are starting to get hit. But we get some bad news. Kerry Reedy will miss the rest of the playoffs with a quad tear, out 7 weeks. So that is unfortunate. Travis Etienne will have to take over. So we find out who we play in the NFC Championship, and look who it is. It's the Redskins once again. Remember, 2 seasons ago, we faced them in the NFC Championship and lost. And now we will get our revenge, which we already kind of got because we did beat them before after that. But now, once again, we have them before the Super Bowl again. And remember, this is our 3rd straight NFC Championship. This is a huge feat for this roster. And as we kind of defend this title, we could be headed to our 2nd straight Super Bowl. So that's going to do it here in this episode. Hit subscribe. Hit that like button. Stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go. Yeah, hey, filling out these job applications. Life got hard after high school graduation. I went to college and your boy got financial aid. They gave me money, then I went and bought a pair of J's. And I bought a pair of shades. And I bought a new computer. Half $400 left, spent the rest on...